What are the seven areas I've told you? Can anyone tell me? Fine. Yeah. Can anyone tell me what are the seven questions we had to know all about a business plan? In order or randomly, anyone?
Sir, what is a business plan?
One.
Why business plan?
Two.
To whom that business plan?
To whom you write the business plan?
How to write a business plan?
How to write? Good.
How to execute a business plan?
Okay.
Who should write that business plan?
Whom to send the business plan? Good. That's all.
What should it consist of? Business plan should consist.
Structure of the business plan. Okay. These are the seven broad areas. If you remember, you all can write your own business plan. It's quite easy. Okay. Meghna, did you get the summary of all our friends?
Meghna? Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Everyone have given?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Good job done. I think that is also shared in the WhatsApp group.
Yes, you can, I have both shared.
Okay. So now I'll just put you some questions. Quickly respond something. Okay. So what are the important areas that you have to consider or keep in mind when writing a business plan?
So one is market conditions.
Market, good. Yeah. So, and as Tanuja was saying, the scope of the business or structure of the business plan, there we discussed stakeholders, your customers, your suppliers, you know, your own team, employees, whoever it is, how do you delegate them? How do you give the JD for them? How do you organize them? How do you manage them? So everything is part of the business plan. Maybe let us go with some examples. Can anyone share about your own business model? How can you write a business plan? Please share your business model and try to talk something about your plan. Any business, anyone?
So,
yeah.
My business model is MSME based, sir.
Sorry?
MSME based business model.
Okay.
And
no, that is, we all are clear. We are talking only about small business.
Yes, sir.
So it's not even MSME. It is only small business. Okay. So what is a business model? Let us know, Meghna.
So it is a you know, like model means what, sir? Can you just explain me once? Means
no, what should I say? Well, who else will try? What is it? Talk about your business, as simple as that. Y'all gave me what business you wanted to start. Even Meghna has done it, right?
Yes, sir.
Talk about that also. Some said food, some said boutique, some said travel.
So it's
about handicrafts.
It's okay. A small animal husbandry which deals with milk production and its byproducts.
Okay, so animal husbandry, it talks about products and it talks about don't be conceptual. You should talk as if you're doing the business and starting the business. That's what I'm testing.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah, can you continue? Or shall we take others?
Let others say, so then I'll.
Yeah, good. That's a good start. Thank you, Meghna.
Yes.
Others?
Sir, my business model is a type of partnership. I'm starting a paper cup business.
What? You should be very clear now. Okay? We are not talking about concepts. Yeah. Go on.
I started paper cups and plates business, sir. So that
paper cups are, and plates. You told us you were missing yesterday.
Yes,
is it
sir.
The same maker what Pawan is talking about?
Yes, sir. That's good. The business.
Go ahead, Pawan.
Sir, people are very much interested about starting the restaurants and all. Due to this pandemic situation, people are not using the pinganis or other plastic plates and all. So people are many using only the paper plates. That's why I got this idea to produce these paper cups and paper bags or paper plates so that they can use or utilize it at a one-time purpose. It is a use and throw process so that I can grab
but
the market.
That is there even before COVID-19 also, no?
Yes, sir. But I can get huge sales in this time. That's okay. What I'm saying. I get huge
it is more
profit.
Of demand. It's more of a yes. Need now.
Very yes, good.
But what is your business plan out of this? Idea is good. How do you make money? What is your business model?
Sir.
Say, for example, Meghna said animal husbandry. Maybe she's talking about milk products. Okay. Yes, I thought it's only milking, but she also told that milk derivative products. Okay. Pawan is saying paper cups, paper plates kind of thing. So that is the idea you have. Business model means how do you make money out of it? That's important. Say, in the case of Meghna, are you trying to do the milking process in your own backyard? You have a piece of land. That is one way.
Yes.
Otherwise, are you trying to pull up, buy the milk from all the farmers in a village? That is the second one. All the milk products are ready and they're ready packed. And do you want to sell the packed milk products? So what is your business model? Coming to Pawan.
No, sir.
Sir, I have to buy the products which I need from the other parties.
Wait for me. For coming to Pawan, he said paper cups and paper plates. So what? That is the idea he has to do business. But what to do? You want to manufacture the paper plates and paper cups, or you want to become a wholesale distributor of these products, or you want to sell as a retail outlet? Or you want to sell online, or you don't want to buy and sell, but you just give the service. Whoever is buying, whoever is selling, you just give the service of these products. There are many business models within this product. Got it?
Yes,
anyone
sir, yes,
else? Yeah, it's good. You can talk about a business idea also, no problem. I will help you how it has to happen, like I was telling Meghna and Pawan. Others? So I want to know about food business. Many said food.
Sir, Saipriya.
Saipriya? Are you there, Saipriya?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, go ahead.
Sir. Sir, I want to do online food service, food business. Like, I want to start a small cooking room. One signature recipe.
So you already
start with that. No. We will.
The process to innovate or create that.
What, sir?
That food recipe, which is unique, you have to think about it or it is ready.
It is ready, sir.
Okay. So how you want to sell that?
We are thinking like that. Zomato.
Right? Oh, you want to give it to Zomato?
Yes, sir.
Okay. I think you know KFC?
Yes, sir.
Okay, who is the founder of KFC?
Couldn't remember his name.
Sorry? Tata.
No, sir. I couldn't remember.
Couldn't remember. Oh my God. What an answer here. You don't know, couldn't remember. Both are same. We want answer. No one can tell me who is the founder of KFC.
Colonel
Sir, Sanders. Colonel.
Sorry?
Colonel Sanders.
Correct. So I had a quick Google search. Yeah, good. At least that is good. Smart student, smart work. I appreciate that. So like Sai Priya was saying, she wants to make a unique recipe and give it to Zomato kind of food aggregators. Maybe that's a good idea. Colonel Sanders, you know, he's the one. Maybe in many WhatsApp, Facebook motivational videos, you might have heard about Colonel Sanders. Till his late ages, he has been trying, failing, and at last he succeeded kind of thing. Actually, he didn't succeed. You know that? He had a unique, the KFC that we are having right now, that was his formula, his innovative recipe. He went to hundreds of restaurants in USA to get the loyalty and have a happy retirement life. He didn't want to work out. And then instead of going for everyone, then he started selling that in his own colony in USA. Then it is a big hit. Then later he sold this formula to someone else. He didn't make big money out of it. So when you say unique recipe, it should be yours, Sai Priya. You cannot, in India, we don't have that system of getting the royalty. That's very tough. Okay. Maybe you can become a good cook. If you want to give it to others, you can get into a big star hotel, you know. Maybe they may demand hotel management kind of diploma or course or undergraduation or master's. And they pay you high, you will be mastering that technique. Okay. That is one way of looking at it. But still, you can find out. But there is one program on TLC, Travel and Living Channel. TLC, I don't know how many of you are aware. Every day, afternoon, 2:30, 2:45 to 3:55, if I'm not wrong, or 2:55 to 3:45. I'm a big fan of that program. It is Restaurant Impossible. Robert Irwin, those who are interested in food, you have to write this. Please write it down, all of you. TLC is the channel dedicated to food. Okay, you have Cutthroat Kitchen, you have Restaurant Impossible, you have many in the channel. You should be innovative. Why you have to be innovative and creative in food business? He explains a lot. Okay, my family member says he's like me. Then I started watching why he's like me. Right. So watch Robert Irwin. He renovates restaurants in just 2 days. In 2 days, okay? In New York, Las Vegas, California, Miami, there are different places. He renovated 100 plus restaurants. It is aired on TV show. It is a 1 hour program. The repeated shows are coming. You can search in YouTube channel also. But I suggest you to watch on TV. Robert Irwin. Restaurant Impossible. It comes on TLC channel. Try that, Sai Priya. Okay. So I'm just taking your business models. I want you to be very clear on how do you make money out of your business idea. That is, that becomes your business model. Yeah. Anyone else? Can you pick someone in boutique, Meghna?
So, Pravalika?
Talk about your business model, Pravalika, or business idea.
Sir, I want to start boutique, sir.
Talk about that only. Talk about your boutique business idea, how you want to do, how you want to make money, you know, how you want to make that as a career. Talk in your own way. Yeah.
First, I want to choose which type of boutique I want to start, is like clothing or footwear or anything. And next, I want to see where locations here and how the from where I have to funding sources. And next, which type of fabric I want to choose. And next, how much I want to put the price for the products what I have.
Okay, maybe you are mixing the plan and the model. I should say that, Pravalika, what you have to do is, as you rightly said, that you want to pick something in boutique. First, you be sure that in this boutique business, which specific area you want to target. Okay, what kind of customers you are looking at, which place, which location, what service exactly you want to give it to others. That should be very clear to you. Okay. So do that homework today itself. From next time onwards, this thing, you should be in the next step. You should be elevated to the next. You should be very clear so that you can draw, you can write a business plan for your own boutique business. Okay, fine. I think someone said resorts yesterday. Sunil?
Sunil, 55. Sunil, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Are you there, Sunil?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please go on, talk about your business.
Yes, sir, I want to start a resort, sir. I would like to plan resort in hill station, sir, because there is a cool breeze coming from the surroundings, sir. Sir, we see so many resorts in that area, sir, hill stations, but they could plan and the cost of the restaurants, resorts is very high, sir.
Hang on. Now, you are generalizing very much. Hill resort. You should be very specific. Where you want to start? Is Arakku, Paderu, Lambati, Arakku Hills, Kuti, Kodaikanal?
Arakku, sir.
Darjeeling?
Arakku, sir.
Arakku?
Yes, sir.
You already have that in your mind?
Yes, sir.
Did you go there?
Yes, sir. Many times.
So you want to buy piece of land or you want to lease out?
Lease of land, sir.
Sorry?
Lease of land, sir.
Lease? Buy. You know how much, yes, is the lease?
No, sir. I'm trying to...
Everything is in aid. Don't be like that. Be very practical. You know how much is the lease amount?
Maybe...
What do you mean by lease? In Arakku area, people cannot sell piece of land to you. It belongs to tribal people. They inherit that land. They inherit the culture. Okay? So it is the government rule that they cannot sell land to outsiders. Now, how do you take lease? So what they're doing is, instead of selling the land, they're entering into agreement of lease for 99 years. It's almost like selling. Okay. So acre land, long term back, it was 3 lakhs per acre leasing for 99 years. It has become 6 lakhs, 7 lakhs. I don't know what is the latest price. You have to check out these things.
Okay.
Cool breeze is so good to hear. It is so good. Everyone loves it. But where is the land? How do you build the resort? You think about all these things. Okay. So food is over, animal husbandry over, boutique over, resorts over. Any other different business? Paper plates and paper cups got over. We got 5.
Sorry, event management.
Sorry?
Event management.
Who is that?
Next, it is there, sir. Event management. Most of the students have picked at.
Pick one.
Sir, Maulika.
So now everyone will be cursing Meghna instead of me.
Maulika, sir.
Yeah, pick one, Meghna.
Sir, Maulika.
Maulika? Are you there, Maulika? Okay, pick someone else.
Sir, Lalita.
Yeah, Lalita Bhavani.
Yes, sir.
Yes, Lalita.
Sir, as I already mentioned, I want to start an event management type of business now, sir. So I will talk with the catering services, sir. So I will talk with the catering services and I'll make sure that I'll just start with the my own locality people, sir. First thing, I'll not go with.
No,
sir. Vishakhapatnam, sir.
Where in
Vizag? Near Karshed, sir.
Okay. Oh, Madhurwada area. Okay.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So in my layout only, first I'll start. I'll just tell them that this type of services we are providing. So do consult us. Then I'll get to know in my locality. So it will be useful for me also to know how well I can do. Means if I start it in a wider way, no sir, I don't know what the problems will be exactly. So if I start in my layout, so then I'll get to know what are the problems, then how fast I can do it or how slow I can do it and how many members I can take and everything, sir.
Okay, that's a good idea, but I suggest write it down. If you have all of you, keep a notebook and pen with you. This is to Lalita. When you talk about catering business, Lalita, are you having your own team or you want to do a intermediary role?
Sir, actually, I know a person who is doing catering business, sir. So I'll make up with them, and if any of if they are managing, event management is not only concerned with catering, no sir, it is concerned with event decoration and everything, no sir. So no, we'll
is catering services or event management?
Event management, sir. We'll do event management, we'll do decorations, we'll do everything, sir. Catering, including catering, we'll do everything.
So apart from catering, in an event management, what are the major areas, Lalita?
Decoration, sir.
Decoration, catering, then?
Decoration, catering.
First, we have to get it. Okay? That's the reason I was asking you. You want to do catering or event management? Event management is much bigger, very big. Okay.
Means that is event based management. On the event, sir. Means based on their function, we'll then decide what are their
event. Even the class we are taking right now, this is an event. Okay. You all are ready with your audio, video, cameras, background, lighting. I should be ready with you all. It is getting recorded. Then it has to be edited. I'm trying to upload with you all and share. Then I'm in the next session, I'm following up with the same class in the next session. So there are many things. Let it be small event, big event, in your area, in your layout, or out of Madhurwada, anywhere. Event is an event. Event is bigger when you talk about catering. Okay? Catering is very small. Catering is one aspect. As you told, one is decoration, other one is catering. There are many. Like acoustics. Acoustics is very important. There is no event without sound system. If you have singers, if you have dancers, you have mimicry artists, you have magicians, you have to bring some artists. You have to manage them.
No, sir. I'm not planning of doing those kind, but I'll be talking with the people who have the sound systems and everything. Then I'll provide everything as a whole to the people. Sir, I can't hear you, sir.
Sir, it's a voice business model.
Sir, voice is not clear.
Now, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, my point, my idea, my point to Lalita is, Lalita has to be clear now. If I'm not wrong, now you are trying to get clear with your business ideas. Okay, you never done it. This is the first time you're exploring. There's nothing wrong in that. So when you talk about event management, whether it is you're getting all the resources by yourself or you're outsourcing them, but it is your responsibility. Everyone will ask Lalita, Lalita, where is that? Where is he? Where is she? Everyone will call Lalita, not others. So event management is much bigger. So if you want to manage events and make money out of it, you should get some experience out of it, because it is more about people management. Operational management. How do you manage the operations? I wish you were writing all these things, Lalita. These are very important. So first thing is, you have to write down what are the major areas in event management. You have to order it down. Then within that, how do you coordinate all? It is by your own people or you're going to outsource. Okay? Talk about costs and other things. I wish you got my points, Lalita.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So work on these areas, go to the next level. Then you'll understand. One major thing I want to share is, you told that you want to do in your own layout. If you're planning to do in your own layout, you're limiting your business. You can't expect events every month or every week. Okay?
I want to first start in my layout, then see the pros and cons.
That's what I'm saying. Let it come. Let it be started in college. Let it be started with some of your friends. You cannot say that it's not in your hands. Okay. When, how, where, and who gives you the business opportunity, you never know. Okay. So yes, let us not limit ourselves that we'll do here, we'll do there. Be open, but your business model should be very clear. Got it, Lalita?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, good. So any other industry? Okay. I think we got good examples today to share. Why I had been asking you all is, first thing is, you all will be clear about your own business models. Okay? Apart from that, once you're clear with your business model, you will be working on your business plan. You got the conceptual inputs. You got a session, in the previous session, you got some inputs on what is a business plan, how to start, or how to write a business plan, what is the structure, what it contains, and so on. But you have to apply that to you. It is not for exams. It is not for marks. It is not for grades. It is for you. Fit that business plan into your business model. Then you will understand the realities and you will know where do you stand to do business. Okay? So that is how you have to integrate your own business model with your business plan. And further, when you talk about your business, your planning process, broadly we discussed, I think in the business plan in the previous session, I was clearly saying the structure of a business plan. You should divide the whole business into functions. Okay? Like, for example, Lalita was saying event management. Okay? In the event management, what are the functions? Key functions. Decoration is one. Catering is one. Acoustics is one. Anchors and other key people, it is the other one. So there are different functions in this. Whatever the functions you have, each function should have a plan, should have a forecasting for the future. What next in the next month? What next for the new year? What's your plan for Christmas? What's your plan for Sankranti? What's the plan for next quarter, next 1 year, next 2 years, next 3 years? How do you plan? Okay? That kind of a planning should be done. So it is easy, you know. We have a lot of self-confidence. We praise our own business ideas. But idea is not for us. If you want to make money, the idea should be accepted by others. Who are the others? Who are they?
The market, sir. Market,
customers.
Public.
Or market.
Customers,
they should accept your idea. They should accept your idea. Then only they will come to you. Then only they will demand your product, then only you will make money, then only you will grow every week, every month, every quarter, every year. Okay, so for that what you have to do is sales forecast, sales plan. How many events, coming back to Lalita, how many events you want to plan? Paper cups, paper plates, how many in the coming year 2021? Animal husbandry and milk products, how many products you have, and under each product what will be the sales in 2021? Okay, Cypri was talking about a unique food recipe. What recipe is that? Who is your target customer? How many units you want to sell through Zomato or someone else for the 2021 year? That should be your plan. Okay, when business model is ready, you know your target segments and everything is clear. Okay, so plan your sales. Once you plan your sales, then you can plan income. Okay, so how can you plan income? You have to know your cost or expenditure. So forecasting sales, forecasting income, forecasting expenditure, these three are very important. Then after that, what should be your assets? What would be your probable liabilities? Okay. Then someone was talking about funding. Is that Pawan Kalyan or Sunil? Someone was talking about financing and funding. Okay. So if you invest today in your own small business, how do you get back your money? When do you get back your money? How much time it will take? That you have to be very clear. In your business economics session, break-even analysis is taught to you. Remember? Sir, alanti vanna adugudu sir antara. Exam ayipoyindi kada, grade school second semester kuda ayipoyindi. How dare you ask?
Sir, we remember.
Sorry?
Where there is no profit and no loss.
Correct. Break even is the point where there is no profit nor and loss, neither profit nor loss. That means you have met your you got your fixed costs. You got your fixed costs. Okay, that's what you call it. Any idea what is the formula for break even? Break even point in units. Break even point in units. So before that, you should know how to price. Pricing is also important here. Before doing sales forecasting, you should know what is your product, what are the expenses, costs, then what should be your profits, what is the target profit. Okay, so any idea what is the formula for break even point? Anyone? You know that, but you are not sure whether it is right or wrong. Anyone? No one? Searching. Everyone is searching. Sorry? What is the formula for break-even point? No one?
Sir, fixed cost by contribution margin per unit.
Correct. If you want to know, like again coming to Lalita, she said event management. How many events you have to do for based on an average price for one event? How many events you have to do in a year or in a quarter or in 2 years so that you will recover all your investments or costs? That is what you call it as break-even point in units. Pawan Kalyan was saying the formula as, what is the formula, Pawan? Repeat.
Fixed cost by contribution per unit.
Fixed cost?
by contribution margin
total per unit cost. Total fixed cost divided by contribution per unit. What is the formula for contribution per unit? Sales per unit minus cost per unit. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Is it right?
The sales minus variable cost.
What is the contribution?
Sales minus variable cost.
Sales minus variable cost or profit plus fixed cost per unit. That is your contribution. Good. So total fixed cost divided by contribution per unit will give you break-even units. Okay. In break-even sales, what is the formula? Turnover. If I reach this turnover, I'm at break-even. What is the formula for that? Anyone? Okay. It is total fixed cost by divided by contribution margin, contribution ratio. That will give you turnover ratio. If you reach sales in that to that level for a period of time, in months, in quarters, or in years, then you will start making profits out of it. Okay, fixed cost is flat, variable cost increases, sales is above fixed cost and variable cost. So the total cost removed from sales is your profit. Okay. So you have to think about all these things with your own business model. Do some homework for tomorrow's session. We'll talking all these things practically. I may pick you up randomly. Those who have done some homework, better to speak out. It will be helpful for others also. Yatish is here. Yatish.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
He's not there, sir.
Rajshekhar is absent. So just interested, having good ideas, interested, excited.
Sir, we are not able to hear you.
Business, work on exactly is a good plan. Your business plan will be clear if you have pricing clear. Please, all of you write down. Please, all of you write down. All of you write down. Be clear about number one, business idea, business model. Pricing, location, target customers, online or offline or both, funding, people or teams or groups, sales forecast. You have to tell me in the coming year how much sales you want to do, because you know your price, you know your business model. Sales forecasting, income forecasting, expenditure forecasting, or you can put it as sales forecasting first, expenditure cost forecasting, then income forecasting, profit forecasting, assets, liabilities, budget where you can identify cash flows or cash budget, you can call it as, then break even. Don't worry too much. When I ask you, just you respond, I will help you. Okay. Don't feel, what is this? We didn't start any business. Sir is asking to do all these things. But don't worry too much about it. I'm here to discuss your problems. I'm here to help you. I'm here to give more input. Okay. So be ready with all these things. We'll discuss in tomorrow's session. That's it for the day. See you tomorrow. Thanks for your participation. Bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.